Hi there, I'm here to talk to you about HIIT workouts. HIIT workouts are some of my favorite workouts because they're always different. You can customize it to however much time you have available, what your mood is, what you're feeling like working, and it keeps things interesting. So HIIT stands for High Intensity Interval Training, and I'm going to start by telling you the benefits of HIIT workouts to sell you on them, and then I'm going to teach you how to create your own. So the first benefit is you'll burn more fat. The intensity of HIIT workouts kicks up the body's repair cycle into overdrive, and you'll burn more fat and calories in the 24 hours after your HIIT workout than if you were to do, say, a steady state cardio. So that's a great reason to look towards HIIT workouts to add to your fitness. Number two, you'll build a healthier heart. It pushes you into the anaerobic zone, and that gives your heart a great workout. Number three, no equipment is necessary. You can certainly use equipment if you want. I like to do that occasionally, but you certainly don't need to. And this allows you to really be able to take it anywhere because you don't have to have equipment. Number four, you'll lose weight but not muscle. Steady state cardio can encourage muscle loss. And when I say steady state cardio, I mean anything that you're doing for a long time over and over, like running, the elliptical, even cycling. But when you do a combo of weight training and HIIT workouts, you're better able to preserve the muscle you've earned, and the weight loss will come from your fat stores instead of your muscles. So that is a big win. Number five, you'll increase your metabolism. HIIT stimulates the production of your human growth hormone, or HGH, by up to 450% in the 24 hours after you complete your HIIT workout. And this hormone is responsible for keeping us young on the inside and feeling young on the inside and looking young on the outside. So more of that is always a good thing. Number six, you can do it anywhere. And I talked about this earlier because you don't have to use any equipment. But I love to take my HIIT workout outside on nice days. You can take it to a park. You can do it in your basement. You can do it anywhere and everywhere, really. You can use the time constraints you have. So anywhere from 8 minutes to 1 hour can be considered a HIIT workout. Now, I don't know that I've ever done a HIIT workout for an hour straight. That's a long time. But as long as you get at least 8 minutes in, it counts. Okay, and number seven, it's not boring. I really get bored easily, so it's very important for me to keep things new and fresh, and HIIT workouts do just that. Okay, so now that I've talked about all the benefits of HIIT workouts, I want to explain how to create a HIIT workout. So you can certainly use the internet. You can Google, 20-minute HIIT workout. You can Google, or Pinterest. Pinterest is great too. You could say 10-minute booty HIIT workout, 30-minute ab HIIT workout. You can find anything related to HIIT workouts. So you can do that and screenshot them or save them to your phone, and there you go. That's simple. If you want to customize it though, I'm going to show you how. So it's based, this type of exercise is based on performing a set move for at maximum effort for a brief period of time. So think anywhere from 20 seconds to 60 seconds performing the same move. So maybe if the move was high knee, which I need a little more room here, but high knees are when you run and bring your knees up. 20 to 60 seconds of that. Now, 60 seconds of high knees, 60 seconds of mostly anything is a long time. You can certainly use the 60-second intervals, but I would combine those with 20-second intervals so that it's not just 60 seconds, 60 seconds, 60 seconds. And then after your interval, you've got a brief period of rest. So my favorite HIIT workouts are like this. 30 seconds of a move, 30 seconds of a new move, 30 seconds of a new move, 30 seconds of a new move, 20 seconds rest. Repeat. 30, 30, 30, 30, 20, rest, repeat. And I do that 3 times. And I learned this style of workouts from Insanity. I'm an Insanity instructor, and that's how they structure the workouts. And I find that I really like that 30-second interval because it's long enough to be hard. You know, by the end of it, you're ready for the new move, but it's not so hard that it feels impossible. You know, it's just 30 seconds. You can say that to yourself. It's just 30 seconds. When it gets to be a minute long interval, it feels really hard. So I like to keep it around 30 seconds. You can put certain exercise intervals back to back with no rest, like I said, and then insert a rest period. Or you can do, you could do 40 seconds of work, 10 seconds of rest, 40 seconds of work, 10 seconds of rest. So you can really kind of play with it depending on your goals and your needs and all of that. Another type of HIIT that you've probably heard of is called Tabata. Tabata workouts are, so if this is the HIIT genre, Tabata is one of the types of HIIT. And Tabata is like the hardest type of HIIT. It was created by a man with the last name Tabata, and he worked with Olympic athletes on finding the very best way to train them. And he found that training these athletes in these super short bursts of time, like 8 minutes, was better than training them for hours at a time. And it's named after him. Now, the way that Tabata is a little different is that you do 20 seconds of a move with 10 seconds of rest, and you do that for 8 times with the same move. So let's say it was high knee. It'd be high knee, rest, high knee, rest, high knee, rest. And you do that for eight times. And then you do it again with a different move. And you usually have 4 or 5 moves. Tabata workouts should feel harder because you're pushing into that anaerobic zone. You should be breathless. You're working at max effort for HIIT workouts. So, you know, it shouldn't feel easy. You should be pushing the whole time because it's so much shorter. You're getting the benefits condensed into a smaller time frame, so you've got to push the whole time. I like to, let's stop choosing the intervals, and now let's move on to moves before I go into what I was going to say. So that's how you kind of set it up, and you can play with it. You can, you know, like I said, check online and play with some and then customize those based on what you like. But choosing your moves is really the fun part. So choose some of your favorite moves and put them together and create a HIIT. You can mix it up with some plyometric, that means jumping, plyometric moves, and then alternate with some strengthening moves, or cardio moves and then strengthening moves. So here's an example, and I put some of these in the files for you, but one cardio move would be, side to side, you know, shuffle side and reach. So you shuffle, shuffle, let's see if you can see it. Shuffle, shuffle, reach down. Shuffle, shuffle, reach down, but clearly do it faster and with a little more room. So you maybe do that for 30 seconds, and then your next move should be a strengthening move, or could be a strengthening move. So maybe that's push-ups or moving push-ups where you move to the side and move to the other side. Maybe then you go into those high knees that I keep referring to because it's such a great workout. For your whole core and your heart, and it gets your heart rate up. And then you do squat pulses. So you're nice and low, and you're just pulsing, pulsing, pulsing. So I like to do it that way, where I alternate cardio moves, plyometric moves, with some strengthening moves. Now, when you are considering the moves for your whole body, the best moves, if you're thinking like, okay, what are the very best moves that will, you know, give me the results the fastest? You guys, there are 3 main moves that you should incorporate into your workouts all the time. Number one, squats. Squat all day, squat every day. Squat with your legs narrow, squat with your legs wide. Pulse at the bottom, add a weight. Lift a heel and get the inside of the thigh. Squat deep, squat low, squat heavy, squat light, squat, squat, squat. If you build up those muscles, that's the the legs are the largest muscle group in the whole body. So if you build the muscle up on those, you're going to burn more fat even while you're resting. It's just the best way to work your body. So squats all day, every day. The second move is push-ups. Push-ups work your whole body. So your chest, shoulders, biceps, triceps, core, back, and even the front of the legs from a push-up. So, you know, you can do these on your knees, you can do them on your toes, you can do them where you move one hand and then push up, center, move the other hand, push up, so that you're kind of getting a different angle in the shoulder and the chest. There's a lot of variations you can do. I like to put my feet up and then my head down, so I'm pushing up with gravity's helping me, but it's harder because your feet are up, so you've got the weight of your feet that you're pushing up. So I like doing those. Every once in a while, I'll try a challenge where I'll push up and I'll come up and I'll try to lift off the ground or clap. Those are really hard. So add push-ups to your routine. Even if you're on your knees, you're still working the whole body. And then the last move that works your whole body, that's one of the best moves for you, is a plank. So a plank is best done on your forearms, because you really engage your body more. It's a little bit harder than when it's on your hands. But you're gonna put your elbows right under your shoulders, head and neck are in line, so you're not looking down, you're not looking up, you're looking around where your hands are. And your legs are gonna come off behind you. You can be on your knees or your toes. Hips are nice and level. And this is a great workout to, you know, practice adding a little time every single day. Doing a plank challenge really works your core, but not only your core, your legs, your back, your arms, your shoulders, it's a complete whole body move. So I like to incorporate these moves into my HIIT training, but make them a little more fun. So maybe for the plank, it's a plank, and then I open to the side, and I plank, and then I open to the other side, and I do that for 30 seconds. That just creates a little more movement and makes it a little more interesting. And then push-up, you know, doing a moving push-up, like we said, or doing a burpee where you throw your legs back into plank, doing a push-up, coming in. I mean, that's a really fun move, and it incorporates all of those three moves that I told you about. So I hope that's helpful. Go create some HIIT workouts, add them to your routine. I do HIIT workouts at least twice a week, and I do them in place of my cardio. So I'll do either a run or a HIIT workout. I like to run just because I like to be outside, but I only do that about once a week or so. So, HIIT workouts are just so great, you guys, for fitting into your schedule. You don't have to work out for hours and hours to see results. 8 minutes to an hour. 8 minutes, everybody's got 8 minutes, right? So hope you enjoyed that and hope it was helpful. I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.